I don't even know how it's November, but what is going on, guys? It is your boy, TKD, 1-2-D here, back in your place in Source. And of course, we have a new month that means a new batch of PS Now games that have been added to the service to use for your subscription. So of course, this month will bring us PS5, PS5 games like Spider-Man Miles Morales, Demon's Souls, Sackboy, all that great stuff. But let's go over what you could be playing or streaming on your PlayStation 4 and of course your upcoming PS5 in the month of November. First things first here to kick off, we have F1 2020 coming to PlayStation Now. British racing studio Codemasters roars back onto Formula 1 racetrack with an extensive range of new gameplay modes headlined by the immersive My Team. Create your own F1 team, driver, teammate, engine supplier, and more, then compete on the grid for championship glory. Split-screen racing caters for competitive households, while online races will let you take on fellow fans worldwide. So F1 did garner a lot better of a score than I thought it would garner, honestly, at 86. That's no slight towards, you know, F1 2020. I'm sure it's a fine game. I just wasn't expecting an 86, but they did garner that, and the game did come out this year back in July. So it looks like this is going to be a pretty good game in terms of, we typically don't see brand new games come to PlayStation Now that often. So if you want to check out a, British Formula 1 racing game with, game modes and all that online, split screen, all that great stuff, you can look no further than F1 2020 on PlayStation Now. Next up here, we have a sequel to a game that I've been dying to play for so long, Injustice 2. Mortal Kombat developer NetherRealm Studios brings its fighting expertise back to the DC universe in a super-powered brawler sequel. Don the cowl of comic book icons such as Batman, Aquaman, and other larger-than-life characters as they battle it out in new environments on an epic scale. With the gear system, you can fashion the look and fight strategy of your chosen hero, powering them up with character-specific equipment. So, Injustice 2, I've heard so many good things about this series. I have seen a little bit about the comics. I haven't read them, but I've just, watched some recap videos about the comics. It seems like a very, very cool narrative, and I know a lot of people definitely, hold this story up to a pedestal in terms of it being really, really good, and you can stream it on PS Now for this month and for the foreseeable future, and also it garnered 87 on Metacritic, so it is a pretty good game, honestly. Like, with the 87, it's definitely not something to look over, and at some point I will definitely check out the Injustice series at some point. Next up, what's crazy to think about is that now this IP is essentially owned by Microsoft at this point. It is, of course, Rage 2. When you couple id Software's FPS pedigree with Avalanche Studios' open world prowess, Rage 2 invites you to enjoy ludicrous vehicle combat, superpowered first-person mayhem, and an open world full of emergent madness. Tear through an unforgiving wasteland battling ferocious factions to find upgradable weapons and devastating nanotripe powers to crush the oppressive rule of the Authority once and for all. So I do remember when this game was coming out. It came out actually last year around May. By that time I was playing through Days Gone and different stuff like that, so I wasn't really clicked in on this game. I didn't play the first Rage. However, I do know that this game didn't perform that well in terms of Metacritic and the critical reception of the game, giving it a 67 on Metacritic. So not the greatest thing in the world, but I do know that I'm a fan of it, at least, you know what I'm saying? So like this year they did Doom Eternal. I was a big fan of Doom Eternal. So, I mean, if it's anything like that, even though I hear that, it is a little bit lackluster and not really the best game in the world, I would at least consider it a try, at least on PS Now with my subscription. Who knows? Maybe I will, but if you want to check it out for yourself, it is on PS Now starting this month. And lastly here on the main rotation, we have My Time at Portia coming to PS Now as well. Split your time between being an adventurer, farmer, and engineer in this enchanting sim set in a charming post-apocalyptic land. Restore your PA's neglected workshop to its former glory by fulfilling commissions, growing crops, and raising animals. Want to take a break from crafting? Befriend Portia's quirky inhabitants and take part in the town's many mini-games, or strike out to explore and battle your way through ancient ruins and dungeons. So I wasn't really looking for this game. I do remember seeing it, I believe, on a Switch conference here in the past few weeks and stuff like that, but it did garner a 75 on Metacritic, so pretty good score. Not that crazy, but pretty good score. And although it's not my jam, maybe it is yours and you can check it out here on PlayStation Now. And the last thing here they did outline on the blog was that there were two other games that for some reason didn't get a trailer and a full description and everything, but I did pull a little bit of info about each game. So first up here, Kingdom Come Deliverance is also coming to PS Now. It is a first-person action RPG set in the medieval kingdom of Bohemia, and it did garner a Metacritic of 69.
Nice.
A 69 Metacritic on that game. And lastly here, we have Warhammer Vermintide 2, which is a first-person action game with a four-player co-op set in a fantasy land, which did garner an 81 on Metacritic as well. So those have been your PS Now games for the month of November. We start from the top here, go straight from the top to the bottom. We have F1 2020, Infamous 2, Rage 2, My Time at Portia, Kingdom Come Deliverance, and Warhammer Vermintide 2 are all coming to PS Now starting on Tuesday, November 3rd, tomorrow, and will go up until the foreseeable future. So that is all we got here, guys. Let me know which games you'll be playing on PS Now. Do you have any thoughts on these games? Did you play them already? Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. And make sure also while you are down there to check out our description, where you can find links to our Discord and Twitter, as well as our Anchor link. That way you can listen to our long form content and podcast format. Those, of course, being Road to PS5 and Road to Miles Morales. Down below, of course, you can hit that join button as well to become a member of the channel. You can be a Prince tier for $1 and a King tier for $5, giving you access to different channel emojis and badges, just like the homies Caleb Kaiser, Arachnite, Owen, Chungi, and Tapiwa Musa. Much love to the homies out there rocking with us on the membership. Much love to you guys. And before you go, make sure to hit up down below to find our Twitter and our Discord server down below, linked in the description. Like the video if you enjoyed it, as well as hit subscribe to PlayStation Source to keep up with the latest and greatest in PlayStation. Thank you all for watching, and as always, greatness awaits.